All right. Forgotten Worlds is a beef-hunk scrolling shooter with two flying piles of meat wearing Ray-Bans and shooting whatever comes their way. And I'm guessing their flight abilities are boosted from all-day steroid injections or the passion of fighting against Egyptian-esque gods that Soldier Red is just a little too excited to try to defeat.
Now I'm gonna do it my way!
Wait, don't underestimate the gods of thunder and wind.
Yeah. Gods of Thunder and Wind are certainly things you might not want to underestimate. Not even with radically cool mohawks. Luckily, Soldier Blue, who has all the enthusiasm of a glass of ice, tells him that before he flies into the sky like all of our great bodybuilders that can magically float without wings. No, it's actually because they have anti-gravity devices that have the ability to make shredded glutes and pecs float blissfully through the air and also give Soldier Red the confidence to say things like this.
I'll burn him with my aura.
Yeah, I mean, there's not even a button in the game that allows you to do that. But, well, I mean, if you look at how they dress, then, yeah. They kind of give a muscle finger to future fashion and style, then go along with the colorful Schwarzenegger from Predator look, knowing all the time that a silly thing like paramecium will not stop Soldier Blue.
You cannot stop me with paramecium alone.
Now, the average human that's built with normal muscular abilities that don't defy gravity might be scared when they find out they have to battle against something named paramecium. Because, for one, it's bacteria. And for two, you have to shoot it. And as we've all learned from our newest pandemic, we haven't learned anything. Regardless, Soldier Blue states that not only can you not infect him with paramecium, you can't even defeat him with it. So that makes him a force to be reckoned with. And once he murders the disease, he's going out with Queen Cleopatra.
Darn it. My date with Cleopatra is spoiled.
Yeah, see, the funny thing about these two sweaty satellites is that they make time for one-liners and jokes between giant futuristic robots that come from Queen and Earth, Wind & Fire album covers. And boy howdy, do they have some knee slappers. Like this one.
He's done for. I'm going to kill him today.
Wait, sorry. That wasn't funny. That was just shockingly threatening and eerily too calm. Here's one.
Was Mescatet's vessel in the air with the flying stone also?
I'm not sure, but he won't be getting seasick anymore.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know what Soldier Red was expecting out of that joke, but I'm sure that Soldier Blue, with his deadpan everything, would have let out a sluggish kind of laugh in return. Oddly enough, though, as confident as both of these meatheads are, they really aren't. And you kind of find out that at the end when Soldier Blue says,
I've done it. I'm still shivering.
Wait, what? You're still shivering? How is that? And Soldier Red even confirms and says,
yeah, me too, man.
Also, I see what Capcom was trying to do with Soldier Red's voice. So what they did is get the blackest guy from Hong Kong that isn't black, but is from Hong Kong, to do his voiceover. And it's just terrible.
No doubt about it. The King of Gods must be saying his prayers now.
Yeah. I'm guessing he either watched Dolomite or a special cut of G.I. Joe that only showed the parts where Roadblock is featured. So yeah. Forgotten Worlds does have the pretty impressive factor of having speech in an arcade game from the late 80s with an outrageous story. So I'll give it a B for sound quality and a C for acting. And here's to hoping that one day they finally find the guy.
Did you find the guy?
No, I didn't.